Look how far down this goes. This is probably one of the biggest SkyBlock maps I have ever seen. What's up, agents? Zero here, welcome back to another Minecraft video. Today we're going to be taking a look at an interesting SkyBlock map I found on MCPEDL. This is called SkyLayer Survival. Now, I've actually had to do a little bit of digging into MCPEDL in order to find this. Technically, I only went 4 pages deep because I was looking for something interesting. This map, as far as me recording this, is actually 1 week old, but with the sheer amount of content that MCPEDL puts out on a regular basis, it kind of got buried. So yeah, I went through several pages to find this, and actually this is an interesting map all things considered. Now, before I go any further, I have to give credit where credit is due, and before I go ahead and say the person who made this, I want to apologize up front in case I mispronounce their name. So this was actually created by someone by the name of Zux. So huge shout out to them. Make sure to check their links in the description, as well as a link to download this map for yourself. Now, actually, when I spawned in this world, I was actually in survival, but I figured I wasn't actually gonna do like an actual playthrough of it. All I wanted to do was go ahead and review the map, so I went ahead and switched this into creative. Hopefully the creator isn't too mad at me for doing this, but yeah, so this is obviously, as you might expect, where I spawn. So we get ourselves a couple of trees, and apparently this is actually all the way at sky limit. So if I go ahead and grab some wood, I try to build, yeah, height limit for building is 256 blocks. So this world is technically at sky limit. And what's interesting is I went ahead and looked at the entire map, and this goes all the way from sky limit all the way down to basically the void, basically. And so this goes pretty much the entire height of Minecraft is basically what I'm trying to say. And so yeah, we're gonna be doing an overview of this map, as I've already explained. And I'm also going to mention, I'm not going to be looking at the entire map because I looked at the entire map. This thing is absolutely massive. So if you guys want to see the entire map for yourself, as I just mentioned, I'm only going to do a small portion of it, then make sure to check the link in the description to download this map, and you guys can see exactly how massive this map absolutely is. This is actually pretty incredible in my opinion. So first off, yeah, as I just mentioned, this is where you're starting off, and I already looked at this. This is a 5x5 chunk, although if you really think about chunks in Minecraft are technically 16x16, but for the sheer amount of stuff that's actually in this map, I'm going to go ahead and let that fact slide, because this is absolutely incredible what this person has done. Because if you go ahead, I'm just going to stand right here. Well, I'm technically flying, but I'm just going to go ahead and look down. Look how far down this goes. This is probably one of the biggest SkyBlock maps I have ever seen. Although, admittedly, I'm talking about, like, in a sheer small amount of area. I do technically play Mega SkyBlock, which has, I don't even remember how many islands, so it is pretty big. And I actually don't know whether this map or Mega SkyBlock is technically bigger, but this does have the benefit of going from all the way down to the bottom, all the way down to the top. So this, it has that going for it. And basically, this is supposed to be, you're trying to get through all these layers as best as you can. And if you can tell, there's actually a number of different features that you're going to end up noticing as you go down. For example, this right here, we actually have ourselves a skeleton spawner, which is kind of interesting, because then that means you have, whatever. So you do actually have access to being able to get like mob drops and stuff, or at least I can tell that from skeletons. I did happen to see, spoilers for anyone who wants to look at this map, I did see other spawners on this map. I cannot guarantee these are spawners for every single mob in the game. I highly doubt it, but you do have a few options at your disposal, which is actually kind of nice. I have not looked at pretty much any of the chests in this map, because I did notice that there are a few chests in this map, and I'm gonna actually let that stay up to you guys to find out what's inside of these chests. But yeah, we've got ourselves quite a few different resources. We have ourselves just starting off a little bit of stone, gravel, a little bit of some common ores, and then we get down to a layer of leaves, a little bit of sand, and then we get down to some fence posts, the skeleton spawner, obviously. If we go further down, you're going to see that we get a little extra stuff, and obviously you're going to notice this as you go further down in this map. That much is fairly obvious. And so yeah, we get ourselves a little bit of a farm in such a tiny area. This the person who made this map did an incredible job jam-packing what they did into such a short amount of space. We go down a little bit further, we get ourselves, I believe this is TheGamingCyclone with a whole bunch of flowers on top of it, which is nice. Then we get a little further down, some sand, red sand, a little bit of soul sand, then we get into netherrack, and then we start getting into colder stuff, snow and ice, and then we have ourselves emeralds and diamonds, which is actually kind of nice, and gold, which is a little bit rare, but obviously not something that everyone strives for. And yeah, this goes, as I mentioned, all the way from sky limit all the way down to the bottom of the world. This is technically on a super flat world. I will go ahead and say this much. This is on a super flat world because it's like pretty much the limit that we have currently to build these kind of things, which makes a lot of sense. But what's interesting, actually, you know what? I'm not going to say, I don't want to spoil that for you guys. You guys are going to have to check this out for yourself. But yeah, this is actually a really interesting map. I really like the idea behind this. So it's basically limited space survival, which actually makes a lot of sense, and you do have to obviously be really careful of what you're doing, because otherwise you're gonna fall down to your death, or you're gonna lose resources, which honestly, dying is probably a little bit more important, or at least that's something that you don't want to do. That's why I feel like it's more important. Anyway, with that way, I think this is actually a good place to go ahead and end off the video. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed. If you did, make sure that like button. One more than make sure that subscribe button for future content. Also, you can follow me on Twitter at HNCPU0 to stay updated. This is Mizzou Studios. Thank you guys for watching. And with that, I will see you guys later.